Time for a deeper look into the markets. As you may remember from last week, Zach Ashmore has taken over that section of the show. Zach?
In the news, you've probably heard about African swine fever affecting hog herds all across China. It's a disease that's affected pork markets all around the globe. Farm Week wanted to take a closer look into the problem.
African swine fever, also known as ASF, is a virus that originated from its namesake, Africa, and usually infects warthogs, bush pigs, and other wild swine, causing debilitating symptoms, and most of the animals that get it die. We've known about it for over a century, and it's stayed in Africa for the most part. However, due to human activity, it's accidentally traveled to other parts of the world, such as Europe and Asia. How could it make its way to America? Dr. Carla Houston explains.
African swine fever is what's considered a transboundary animal disease or foreign animal disease in the United States, which means we don't have it here and we don't want it. And actually, we've never had African swine fever here in the United States. So the virus survives a long period of time in whether it's infected animals or blood or tissues. And one of the concerns is that we get so many products from Asia, especially China, such as feed and feed products and protein products, that the virus can actually be introduced by using those types of products here in our animal or agriculture industries.
Dr. Houston says the disease doesn't affect humans, even if we eat infected pork. But economic damage caused to swine herds can devastate the food supply, because she says pork is the most consumed meat in many countries. So, how are we protecting ourselves here in America? The USDA and other organizations have taken the lead.
They have the agriculture checkpoints on the borders coming into the U.S., and they've ramped those up, and they've put out a lot of educational campaigns. The pork industry in the United States is doing a fabulous job in educating people as well as swine producers on how to make sure they have good biosecurity practices, being careful not to have any contact between feral animals and domesticated animals, and then being cautious on what we bring back into the country when we've been overseas.
Unfortunately, current treatment for the disease is to quarantine and kill the infected animals. Vaccines and treatments are being researched, but it'll take time. There could be a day that ASF no longer plagues the world's pork supply. Until then, experts and producers are vigilant.
Houston says it's easier than you think for ASF to cross borders. So far, the U.S. pork supply is safe. For now. The effects of ASF can be felt in other markets as well. China's been importing meat sources to feed its population. No small feat, to be sure. Bloomberg reported that Mississippi-based Sanderson Farms shipped 24 tons of chicken feet, also known as paws, to China.
It is yet unknown, frankly, how much exactly China will buy. We do believe they will buy every chicken paw we can produce, and they're willing to pay anywhere from 80 cents to a dollar a pound for them. Leg quarters trade for 40 cents a pound, so they're willing to pay twice what the market bears for leg quarters for chicken feet. And we produce more than 80 million pounds of chicken feet a year. And you can do that math. If they're willing to pay 80 cents to a dollar a pound, that can mean anywhere from $70 to $75 million to us before taxes. We think also China's demand for chicken meat will elevate prices for other parts of the chicken as well. Again, it's unknowable yet how much they're going to buy, but even if they just buy a marginal amount, it'll help the market.
Earlier in the show, we told you about a significant step forward in trade talks between China and the U.S. I spoke with ag economist Josh Maples for his take on the breakthrough.
With phase one of the China deal that's already been signed, and the USMCA about to be signed, what impacts are these deals going to have in the world of agriculture?
Yeah, that's a great question, Zach, and it's really key to what we're talking about right now. And so if you think particularly about USMCA, the big story is that it just removes a whole level of uncertainty that's been plaguing our markets for the last couple of years without knowing whether NAFTA was going to get continued. So that just removes some uncertainty from ag markets. Canada and Mexico are huge trading partners for us. So that's a big deal in terms of just letting everybody know that things are going to continue. For the phase one China deal, that's been the much anticipated one, right? And the big story there is that, you know, this is really the first significant step towards de-escalating the trade tensions. And we know that U.S. ag has been the hardest hit by the retaliatory tariffs. This particular deal doesn't address, it really addresses the non-tariff barriers more so than the tariff barriers for ag. So there's still plenty of work to be done on getting those tariffs back to previous levels, but it's a big step in the right direction for sure.
And that's it for a deeper look into the markets this week.